Going on, guys? Welcome, Rabid here, and we got a little treat from Bitcoin Merch. So Bitcoin Merch did send this out. This is the Bitaxe 401 Supra, the legendary miner that recently did hit a solo Bitcoin block 3 or 4 days ago. And it is a tiny little thing. Look at this thing compared to my hand. So this does have one single S21 chip within it. I'm going to show you how to set this up and get this thing up and running for solo Bitcoin mining. It's only supposed to use something like 11 watts and get 600 plus gigahash. Let's find out if it does. Before we get going though, I do want to point out this is 100% lottery mining. So a Bitcoin block is every 10 minutes or so. Your chance of actually hitting a block is pretty much zero. You're probably never going to happen. But you miss 100% of the shots that you never take. And this did, in fact, find one already that was worth over $230,000. So it's pretty crazy to think that the possibilities are there. But I do want to point out, yes, this miner was sent to me. Yes, I do have a referral link down in the description if you do want to use it. And yes, most likely you are not going to hit a block on this. So here's our miner. It did come with a power supply, which is this unit right here, as well as the power cord that plugs into the power supply. And I don't think this comes with it, but this was sent as well. It's a USB powered fan. Now, if you have kids, I would highly recommend don't put this anywhere near them. There's no guard or cover. This spins pretty fast. It does blow a decent amount of air. I was surprised. I don't have a portable battery pack to carry this thing around. It is flexible, but this thing will definitely poke out a kid's eye. So be very careful with that. So I did prop this thing up on some mini motherboard stands. As you can see here, it does not come with those because if you look at the bottom, the chips are kind of hanging down. So you're going to be resting like this and that might be bad. So I did like to put it on top of these little stands here. That way it's kind of up off the ground. Okay, so I did power this thing up and it is asking us to connect to a network. So for this, all you got to do is go into your phone and enable Bluetooth and connect to your Bitaxe miner. So it will produce its own little Wi-Fi signal. Just connect to that through your phone and then search anything. If you're on an iPhone, I think it'll just pop up by itself. I'm on an Android, so I just went into my bar, searched anything, and it popped up because it's just the only thing that it does see here. So we can see our dashboard now and all the things that are going on with it, all sorts of various type of things. So we got to set up our miner here. So we come into the dotted lines, we're going to go into our settings here, and now we got to adjust our actual Wi-Fi connectivity. So you're going to put in your normal Wi-Fi SSID settings as well as your Wi-Fi password, and then you can set up your stratum pool and everything. By default, it looks like it's going into, it says publicpool.io. I'm actually going to adjust mine into via BTC. That's where I have my Nano 3. So I'm going to keep everything together. All right, so we are now live, and once you are up and running on your network, you can use your normal PC to simply log into it, just like you would find the IP through any normal ASIC miner. I use my router. It's nice and easy to find the latest connection to my device. So once you find that IP, log in, and here are all your stats. Now, I do want to point out that this also only works on 2.4 gigahertz networks. It will not work on 5G routers and Wi-Fi. So you do have to use the older, slower one, but it does have a wider range and a stronger signal over 5G. But that will only work with the 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi connections here. So now once we're in our dashboard, we can see it's spiking and coming down. It's expected to be about 625 gigahash. We're currently hitting a rate of 705. It was upwards of 850, but we're going to go with numbers of 625 because that's what it's advertised at. I don't have anything for averages, so we don't really know yet. We can see our power consumption here. It is saying 13.6. This is 100% efficiency. We'll be looking at the wall to see how much power this is using exactly. Input voltage is 5 volts. Here you can see our ASIC voltage requested, ASIC temperature currently, our fan speeds at 100, and our frequency and voltage measured here. If we go into our settings at this point, this is where you can also adjust and change your pools if you'd like to on your PC. You can also adjust your frequency up or down if you want to run more efficient or try to get a bit more hash rate, as well as adding that voltages if it starts to crash. Now keep in mind, if you try to overclock this a bit more, you may run into temperature issues and that little fan on it might not keep up, but the option is available. coming into via BTC. I can see that I now have two workers online. If I go to the other one, I can see the Bitaxe Supra 401, which what I did name it, is here live hashing away currently on the 1 hour of 139.8. So I'll come back after a full, maybe I guess I can only come back after a couple hours to see what it's doing at the 1 hour to get a quick average hash rate. We won't know for sure for a full day for 24 hours. So I'm going to let it run for a couple hours here, and then we can get an idea on the 1 hour average here. It should be somewhere over 600 gigahash. And doing a quick look at our power, we are running about 16 to 16.1 watts. Okay, so we are a little over an hour here, and it is looking like we are around that 616 gigahash point. So we are pushing past 600 gigahash here. Coming back into the dashboard, it is down to 583, and it's still saying around 625. So it's going to be interesting to see how this does play after 24 hours. I will try to give you guys an update later on, but right now we do have the Bitaxe Supra 401 solo mining us some Bitcoin, wishing we hit that block again. Most likely, this is not going to happen to you. I want to stress that 100% that the odds of you hitting a block is pretty much zero. But it doesn't mean it won't happen. So it's pretty crazy. Are you going to FOMO into one of these? Let me know down in the comments section. Now, before we get out of here, I do want to kind of compare this to other miners that are on the network and available. So here we have the Nano 3 in low power mode. It's 2.1 terahash, medium 3.2 terahash. It was using 70.2 watts, or 109.5 watts in medium here. I could not get mine to work in high mode. The gigahash per watt is 29.91 in low power mode and 29.22 in medium mode. Now we have the Bitaxe Supra 401. This is about 625 gigahash at 16 watts. This is actually more efficient than the Nano 3, which makes sense because this is coming off Bitmain's latest S21 chip here at 39.062. gigahash per watt of power used, making it looking nice and efficient. Previous generations of the Mars Lander was only 250 gigahash at 18 watts. So you can see we're using less power, getting over 2 to 3 times the hash rate. That's only a 13.88 gigahash per watt. And obviously, Bitmain's latest miner, I guess I don't have the XP here, that's the latest, but the S21 Pro is sitting at 234 terahash, 3,510 watts. That has an efficiency of 66.66 gigahash per watt ratio. And there's something interesting going on. It seems like Bitmain likes the six numbers quite a bit in all their efficiencies on every miner they release. The Alephium ASICs is 6.66 gigahash per watt, and their Kaspa ASICs were around the same as well. That is very interesting numbering by Bitmain. What does it mean? Let me know. All right, guys, so that does wrap up this video. What are your guys' thoughts and opinions on this new Bitaxe Supra 401 based on the S21 chip coming in quite a bit more efficient than previous gens of these nice little lottery miners? I will have links to Bitcoin merch right here so you can purchase for yourself. But then again, guys, remember, this is solo mining. It is lottery mining. You can mine other coins on this. Doesn't have to be Bitcoin, but the majority of people are always like, you know what, let's hit that block. Let's get $200,000 to $500,000 for only 18 watts of power and, you know, get super lucky. Will that happen? Most likely not, but hey, you never know. Anyway, guys, thank you for checking out this video. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.